subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 20th of August. Amid Afghan crisis, Indian Prime Minister Modi says empires of terror temporary. Islamabad is in contact with Taliban, says Pakistan's ambassador to Afghanistan. Nepal's former PM Oli accuses Speaker of partisan behavior regarding expelled party lawmakers. And now for all the details. Security forces early on Friday neutralized two terrorists belonging to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen outfit in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir. This came a day after one Indian Army soldier and a terrorist were killed in a similar encounter in Rajouri district of the Union Territory.
Two terrorists belonging to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen outfit were neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Kriu in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir early on Friday. Security forces had launched a cordon and search operation in the area on Thursday night, which turned into an encounter after the terrorists opened fire upon the security forces. The two terrorists were killed in retaliatory fire, an official said, adding that one of them was involved in the killing of a PN at a government school in the valley on July 23 this year. This came after one Indian Army soldier and a terrorist were killed in a similar encounter in Rajouri district of Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday. India has long accused Pakistan aids terrorists infiltrate across the border to spread unrest in Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan, however, denies the charges.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said empires built through terrorism cannot sustain and would not be able to suppress the humanity for long. His statement during a virtual event came in the backdrop of the Taliban's invasion in Afghanistan. Meanwhile, India's Foreign Minister S. Jayashankar and U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on Thursday discussed the chaotic situation in Afghanistan and agreed to continue their close coordination as efforts are underway for the safe return of stranded citizens in the war-torn country.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said that destructive forces looking to build an empire out of terrorism cannot sustain and would not be able to suppress the humanity for long. The Prime Minister's statement during a virtual event came in the backdrop of the Taliban's invasion and forcible ouster of the democratically elected government in Afghanistan.
Jo todne wali shaktiyan hai. जो आतंक के बलबूते साम्राज्य खड़ा करने वाली सोच है वो किसी कालखंड में कुछ समय के लिए भले हावी हो जाए लेकिन उसका अस्तित्व कभी स्थायी नहीं होता वो ज्यादा दिनों तक मानवता को दबाकर नहीं रख सकता
Meanwhile, India's Foreign Minister S. Jayashankar and U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on Thursday discussed the chaotic situation in Afghanistan for a second time this week and agreed to continue their close coordination. Jayashankar had earlier in the day said that India is working with international partners, principally the U.S., for the safe return of stranded Indians in Afghanistan. On Tuesday, India evacuated hundreds of its citizens, including its ambassador and embassy staff from Afghanistan, in a military aircraft with help of the United States. The Indian Air Force is expected to carry out more evacuation missions from the Afghan capital as soon as operations normalize at the Kabul airport, officials said.
In news from Afghanistan, residents of Afghanistan made observations of a peaceful situation on Friday ever since the Taliban took over the country's capital. More than 18,000 people have been flown out of Kabul since the Taliban's entry, a NATO official said on Friday, pledging to redouble evacuation efforts as criticism of the West's handling of the crisis mounted. Reports suggest that crowds continued to throng outside the airport, desperate to flee on Friday.
Kabul residents flocked to a market on Friday with vendors selling food and drinks following the Taliban takeover of the capital days earlier. A resident said business had not returned to the normal in the big markets because they are closed, although he noted there were many cars on the street. A plane was seen taking off from Kabul airport on Friday, and later people were seen boarding a rescue flight as others could be heard shouting nearby, desperate to flee Afghanistan. Reports have surfaced that crowds continue to throng outside the airport. This comes as more than 18,000 people have been flown out of Kabul since the Taliban took over Afghanistan's capital, a NATO official said on Friday, pledging to redouble evacuation efforts as criticism of the West's handling of the crisis mounted. Meanwhile, the United Nations Refugee Agency UNHRC said on Friday that most Afghans are unable to leave their homeland and that those who may be in danger have no clear way out. Spokesperson Shabia Mantu reiterated the UN agency's call to neighboring countries to keep their borders open to allow people to seek asylum in light of what she called the evolving crisis.
Pakistan's ambassador to Afghanistan, Mansoor Ahmad Khan, on Thursday said that Pakistan is in contact with the Taliban and is facilitating the international community after takeover of Afghanistan by the group earlier this week. He said Islamabad wished to see an inclusive government in Afghanistan.
Pakistan's ambassador to Afghanistan, Mansoor Ahmad Khan, on Thursday said that Pakistan is in contact with the Taliban and is facilitating the international community after the Taliban takeover of Kabul earlier this week. In an interview to a Pakistani TV channel, he said Pakistan wished to see an inclusive government in Afghanistan so it can move towards sustainable peace in the region. The envoy on Thursday also held a meeting with former Afghan President Hamid Karzai and senior leader of the ousted government Abdullah Abdullah to discuss efforts for stability in Afghanistan. Meanwhile, Muhammad Yunus Kanuni, the head of the Afghan delegation of the Northern Alliance, whose U.S.-backed forces toppled the Taliban in 2001, during a press conference in Islamabad, called for an inclusive government in Afghanistan after the Islamist group seized control of the country.
حکومت همشمول مالک بودن یک گروه مهمان بودن بقیه مردم افغانستان در یک نظام این نظام همشمول نخواهد بود.
Earlier on Tuesday, the Afghan delegation of the Northern Alliance had held a meeting with Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan in Islamabad, where Khan assured steadfast support for an inclusive government and also expressed strong support and solidarity for the fraternal people of Afghanistan. Afghan and US officials have long claimed Pakistan enjoys considerable influence with the Taliban and the insurgents have sanctuaries in the country. Pakistan, however, denies the charge.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Political drama was once again witnessed in Nepal this week as CPN-UML chairman KP Sharma Oli removed 14 lawmakers, including senior leader Madhav Kumar Nepal, from party positions for defying party whips. While Madhav Kumar Nepal has sent a request to register a new party at the Election Commission, Oli has accused Speaker Agni Prasad Sapkota of acting in a partisan way by not issuing a notice about expelled lawmakers.
The CPN-UML, Communist Party of Nepal, Unified Marxist-Leninist Chairperson KP Sharma Oli, on Thursday accused Speaker Agni Prasad Sapkota of acting in a partisan way by not issuing a notice about the 14 lawmakers that were recently expelled from the party. Oli had earlier this week expelled 14 UML lawmakers, including senior leader Madhav Kumar Nepal, for defying party whip on May 10 when he, as the Prime Minister, sought a vote of confidence in the House of Representatives. Oli, in an interview with news agency Nepal, said Sapkota repeatedly acted as a mouse guarder and had immediately issued notice about former lawmakers of Janata Samajwadi Party Nepal and CPN Maoist Center when they were expelled by their mother parties. However, he was withholding the process on 14 lawmakers whom his party had recently expelled. Meanwhile, Madhav Kumar Nepal applied for a new party on Thursday with the Election Commission and 13 other lawmakers who were expelled by the establishment faction of the UML. They are with Madhav Kumar Nepal now.
The Indian Army personnel deployed to the Chinese border in eastern India's Sikkim state held drills with Bofors guns on Thursday. The nuclear-armed neighbors have been on the toes since a clash in Galwan Valley last year led to deaths of 20 Indian soldiers and at least 4 Chinese troops. This region witnessed the 2017 Doklam clash, where hundreds of troops from both sides were deployed in 2017 on the plateau near the borders of India, its ally Bhutan and China, after India objected to Chinese construction of a road in the Himalayan area. The Swedish 155mm gun was primarily used during the 1999 Kargil war against Pakistan. It was inducted in the Indian Army in the late 80s.
This gun has got various characteristics. It can fire up to the range beyond 30 kilometers and engage targets therefore. It can fire various types of ammunition as per the requirement. Also, this gun weighs 12 tons. The gun has got an integral APU which helps in the mobility of very short distances.
An octogenarian Indian engineer in India's western Pune city is grabbing eyeballs with his handmade dolls collection that he began well over the age of 50 years. He specifically loves making Japanese dolls as he is specially drawn to their culture.
An 86-year-old engineer from India's western Pune city is grabbing eyeballs with his handmade doll collection that he began well over the age of 50 years. Jayant Sathe's dolls look like performing Indian classical dance forms, going shopping with their children, being ninja warriors and simply tying wedding knots. He specifically loves making Japanese dolls as he is specially drawn to their culture and has been working hard to keep the culture of handmade dolls alive in India.
At the age of 55, I decided now all the family responsibilities are over. So I would do whatever I want to do all my lifetime, which I have been reading in the Reader's Digest for quite some time. In the United States, people, doctor becomes farmers become doctors and all that. I say, why I can't become an artist or a sculptor?
Sathe was a mechanical engineer and worked with various companies till the age of 55, after which he decided to follow his passion and started making handicraft dolls in Pune. To learn the making of Japanese dolls, he travelled to Mumbai, where he learned to make a doll from a lady. When asked about the number of dolls in his collection, he just smiled and said he just keeps making them, so he cannot quote any number as he himself has never counted.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Amid Afghan crisis, Indian Prime Minister Modi says empires of terror temporary. Islamabad is in contact with Taliban, says Pakistan's ambassador to Afghanistan. And Nepal's former PM Oli accuses Speaker of partisan behavior regarding expelled party lawmakers. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.